The use of non-lethal weapons has grown in importance over the last decade due to the rise of counterinsurgency and unconventional warfare. As such, the U.S. military created the Joint Non-Lethal Weapons Program, or JNLWP, which has developed more than 80 devices. Out of those, their most unusual creation is arguably a new laser weapon that makes a unique noise. Instead of burning or blinding possible threats, the striking setup produces an eerie noise that closely resembles the sound of a human voice, thus instilling fear among the enemies. As seen and heard through a piece of footage published by the JNLWP, the ghostly cry emerges as if it came from the underworld, with the program's director even stating, quote, "We're this close to getting it to speak to us. I just need 3 or 4 more kilohertz." A diverse arsenal. The United States Joint Intermediate Force Capabilities Office, a branch of the Department of Defense, defines non-lethal weapons as, quote, "weapons, devices, and munitions that are explicitly designed and primarily employed to incapacitate targeted personnel or material immediately, while minimizing fatalities, permanent injury to personnel, and undesired damage to property in the target area or environment. Non-lethal weapons are intended to have reversible effects on personnel and material." The rise of counterinsurgency and unconventional warfare has drastically changed how armed forces around the globe engage this type of hostile combatant. American forces that have fought in Somalia, Bosnia, Iraq, and Afghanistan experience the duality of not just being infantrymen, but also policymakers with police duties in the cities and towns they visited. Troops would often lead a combat patrol one day, a humanitarian one the next, or even the pacification of an entire town while armed with lethal weapons, such as rifles and explosives. But the way a soldier or marine reacts to an armed guerrilla or terrorist group is different from the way he or she must handle an angry mob armed with only rocks and sticks. With this in mind, the U.S. Joint Intermediate Force Capabilities Office began working with different government agencies to develop non-lethal weapons for use in situations where brute force is not the only option. As U.S. Marine veteran General Anthony C. Zinni put it, quote, "The smart warrior is the one who understands how to use a diverse arsenal of capabilities and isn't afraid to think beyond the traditional way of conducting military operations." Joint Non-Lethal Weapons Program. Since its creation in 1996, the Joint Non-Lethal Weapons Program, or JNLWP, has developed and tested more than 80 non-lethal weapons and systems. These devices range from counter-personnel, counter-material, and counter-capability to handling a wide array of dangerous situations. JNLWP stated in a press release that, quote, "Fielded non-lethal weapon capabilities include blunt impact, marking and warning munitions, acoustic hailing devices, optical distractors, electromuscular incapacitation devices, and vehicle stopping equipment. A rigorous process for evaluating and independently reviewing the human effects of non-lethal weapons has been integrated into non-lethal weapons development." The primary objective of the Joint Non-Lethal Weapons Program is to support national security objectives through the transformation of the national security enterprise by arming the joint force with the fullest range of capabilities. Such purpose includes mainstreaming the planning and employment of intermediate force capabilities. In 2009, it was announced that JNLWP had been working with several agencies on developing directed energy technologies for non-lethal use, including designing a possible man-portable non-lethal thermal laser weapon system. Colonel Tracy Tafala, director of the Joint Non-Lethal Weapons Directorate, told the press, quote, "Non-lethal weapons can provide essential capabilities in situations where reducing civilian casualties and unnecessary damage to property is crucial to mission success. The JNLWP is working to develop new non-lethal directed energy technologies that can help fill capability gaps and provide warfighters with critical escalation of force options." As such, the program developed a design with a more sinister and unique non-lethal purpose, a weapon with a hellish noise. a haunted walkie-talkie. The Pentagon's non-lethal weapons laboratory released footage of a new laser weapon that could only be described as borrowed from a sci-fi movie. Instead of the classic flashlight beam or loudspeaker that would usually keep people away, current technological developments have created a rather creative way to protect sensitive areas as part of the laser-induced plasma effect program, which can create a so-called plasma ball. This phantasmagoric floating orb can do an uncanny trick. It can mimic a human voice, with the purpose of terrorizing enemies with a spooky noise that resembles human speech. As heard in the piece of footage, the artificial voice is not quite yet intelligible. However, scientists are close to achieving their goal of stopping people from charging checkpoints. The effect is caused by an auditory illusion from manipulating the air with lasers. In particular, the weapon alters atoms and creates words from thin air. Remarkably, the setup can act as a reusable flashbang, capable of pulsating 155 decibel frequencies almost continuously. In contrast, standard flashbang grenades can only make one or two loud blasts to disorient enemies. The weapon comprises two parts, a femtosecond laser and a nano laser. The first one belongs to a category of ultra-fast or ultra-short pulse lasers that shoot a burst of focused light for 10 to 15 seconds and rip the electrons from air molecules to create the ball of plasma. The phenomenon is basically a field of electrified gas and is thus highly responsive to electromagnetic effects. The scientists then hit the field with a nano laser tuned to an extremely narrow wavelength and manipulated the plasma to produce light and sound effects. As technology expert and author Patrick Tucker put it, quote, "Get the interaction precise enough, and you'll get something that sounds like a haunted walkie-talkie." An illusion of the optics. Perhaps more interestingly, the weapon can not only create noise, but it can do so at a specific and distant point in space. Chief Scientist Dave Law explained that the next step was pushing distances out of the short range of a laboratory setting to 100 meters, then to multiple kilometers. In an interview with Military Times, Law said, quote, "Now I can put it anywhere. The range doesn't make any difference. Put plasma at a target, modulate it, and it can create a voice." Incredibly, soldiers between the weapon and the target would be unaffected, unlike a blast coming from a nearby speaker. Law continued, quote, "Range is a function of the optics. The bigger the mirrors, the farther the range. A 5-inch mirror, for example, has a range of about 1 kilometer. In contrast, an 8-inch mirror could produce an effect as far as 5 kilometers away." In truth, scientists have created plasmas that work at 20 to 30 kilometers, marking the first time a non-lethal weapon reached tens of kilometers. Furthermore, the beam can pass through glass, though it cannot penetrate solid barriers yet. For the time being, the weapon could be used to defend static areas, such as forward bases or permanent installations. However, with the right power source setup, the device could be mounted on a small vehicle and be used for mobile crowd control to keep people away from convoys or specific areas. Law expects the technology will be fully developed sometime in the mid-2020s before the armed forces can employ it, and he promises many more non-lethal weapons in the next few years. As General Zinni put it, quote, "Non-lethals have a crucial role on today's battlefield and will become increasingly more relevant on future battlefields." Thank you for watching our video. If you enjoyed it, please subscribe to Dark Footage and make sure to give us a thumbs up. Also, hit the bell icon to be notified of our newest videos on military developments and uncanny true stories from the annals of history. And stay tuned for more.